Let's look at how we can create a SAS token. Now I have Visual Studio open and I have a console application. In this console application, I only have a simple NuGet reference to the Azure Storage Libraries. Now this brings in some dependencies, but simply all you need to do is go to NuGet and pull down Windows Azure.storage. I have an empty main method within my program class. And within a Server Explorer, I have access to resources in my subscription. Today, I'm going to use a storage account called Example Store to store it in the East US region. Now, within here, I can create a container for my blobs. I'm going to call this Images Container. And within this Images Container, I can upload blobs. I already have an example blob called SAS Model. If I hit OK, it will upload this SAS Model blob to my Azure Storage account. So the URL is going to be the name of my storage account, .blob.core.windows.net/ the name of my container, and then the name of my blob. The extension is actually pretty much worthless within Azure itself. The extension only has context to your client application. So if I paste this into the browser, I'm not going to be able to access it. The reason being is because this blob container doesn't have anonymous access enabled. I can see this in Visual Studio by right-clicking this container and going to Properties and seeing that Public Read Access is disabled. I can turn on Public Read Access. For the example here, I'm just going to turn it on at the container level. But essentially, this Public Read Access will allow me to anonymously access this blob or any other blobs within this container. If you set it at the blob level, you can anonymously access any blob within the container. If you set it at the container level, not only can you anonymously access blobs, you can also access metadata about the container itself and list blobs within the container. So I hit refresh. And sometimes this takes a couple of refreshes. And you'll see that I have access to this blob. Now I'm going to go back and just turn public read access off so that we can see how we can do this programmatically. So I'm going to turn this off. And go back in here. And after a couple of refreshes, it shouldn't allow me to access it anonymously anymore. There we go, 404 error. Good error doesn't give me any connotation or metadata about what's going on underneath the hood. So the way I can access this programmatically and to generate a SAS token is using the .NET SDK for Azure Storage. Now I can generate the SAS token, I can access it here programmatically, but what we're gonna do for this demo is we're just gonna generate the SAS token so we can look at the SAS token, and then we're gonna paste the SAS token into the browser. So I'm gonna go to my Server Explorer and I'm gonna right click my storage account. And I'm gonna see right here that I have access to a connection string. This connection string is useful sometimes, but it doesn't have access to your actual access keys, pun intended. So you see this storage connection string won't work. So let's actually go back and get a connection string with our access keys. So I'm gonna right click here, properties again, go to storage access keys. You're gonna see that now I have access to these account keys. That's because I'm authenticated to my Azure account already in Visual Studio. I'm gonna copy this connection string, paste it in right here, and that's my connection string. A connection string is built up of protocol, name of account, and one of the account keys. Of course, you could change these values, but it's not recommended to use protocol other than HTTPS. Now that I've done this, I can go ahead and create a cloud storage account instance. And I can do this using cloud storage account static method called parse. Pass in a connection string, everyone's happy. Now I need to create a client. So I'm gonna create a cloud blob client. And that's just done by calling account.createCloudBlobClient. So again, still pretty simple. Now I want access to the container. So it's going to be cloud blob container. And it's going to be blob client dot get container reference. Now this is just a reference to a container. It's not actually doing anything at this point. So if that container doesn't exist, we can actually call container.create or create if not exists. It's just a reference to the container. It's not until you take an action that actually goes verify that container exists. So you can get a 404 error if you try to access a container that doesn't exist because it's simply just a reference. It doesn't do any validation at this point. Now, I can just go in and get a blob. I can call container.get blob reference and use sas model.ping And that would be how could programmatically access this. But for our purposes, we actually want a SaaS token because we want to give somebody temporary access, but we don't want to give them either the access keys or to make our entire container anonymous. We want to just give them singular read access for a specified amount of time. The way we do this is we create what's called a block container permissions object. So I'm going to call this permissions equals new block container permissions. And then permissions dot shared access policies. I'll add a policy to this. I'm going to call this read policy. Create a new instance of shared access block policy. I'm going to set some properties in here. First thing, I'm going to set the expiration time to today UTC time at 24 hours. And I'm also going to give it permissions. At this point, I could give it permissions to read. I can also give it permissions to write, but for our purposes, read is more than enough. Once I've done this, I just simply call permissions.publicAccess, set that to off, well, actually set it, not call it. And now that I've configured this block permissions object, I'm going to set the permissions of this container to this. So I'm just going to call container.setPermissions to that permissions variable that I've been setting all this time. Go in here, and that's it. So for the container, I can actually get a SaaS token. So string SaaS token equals container, get a shared access signature, and use the policy read. So I've actually used the shared access policy to generate shared access signature, but you could just generate an ad hoc shared access signature by specifying the policy right here. But we're doing it the appropriate way. It's always better to specify a policy ahead of time and store the policy in a container and then use that policy later. Since this is a console application, I just call console.writeline, write this SaaS token out, and then console.readKey. That'll keep the window open so I don't have to worry about it closing too soon. So we're going to start this application. And my console window opened up on another screen, but you can see it right here. If we go to properties, I'm going to set this font a little bit higher. You'll see that I have my SaaS token. I could right click here, edit, select all, copy that. And now when I go here, I still can't access that SAS model image, but I can paste this token I just grabbed and hit enter. And I have temporary access to this. And from a programmatic point of view, I can revoke this access. I can do all sorts of interesting things. I can continue to renew the access so that SAS token that I have keeps working. I actually manage this, all SAS tokens generated from this policy, from the policy itself. So it gives you a central point of management for all the tokens you generate.